And I will throw a party for you. A sound, hallelujah, of celebration. He will celebrate with you because God will rescue you out of the trouble. And Isaiah 65 verse 24 says, it shall come to pass that before they call, I will answer, and while they're still speaking, I will hear. While you're still speaking, I will hear. Jesus is talking to every friends.
Hallelujah.
Today, when you are talking, He will grant the request, the answer to all of your prayers. Secondly, friends, not just listen, but friends, share interests. Friends, or genuine friends, always find common ground with us. Sometimes God brings special friends into our lives who have much common with us. Though you may have friends with whom you have no common interests, your best friends have something in common with you. And that is Jesus. Have you experienced to talk to someone and you found out that that person is a Christian? All of a sudden, everything becomes so smooth. And you keep on talking and talking and could not believe that you spend an hour or two talking to this person. Why do you think your conversation becomes so healthy that you don't even notice the time running? Because of Jesus. Because what you are talking about is all about Jesus. You'll become in one spirit and you start understanding one another. You start trying to know each other through the power of our Lord Jesus. I remember the life of Jonathan and David. In the Bible, we all know that Jonathan's dad, King Saul, was trying to kill the promising boy, David. He did everything to kill this coming or next king. Many times, David has an opportunity to kill Saul, King Saul rather. But because of his friendship with his son, Jonathan, he did not touch Saul. Instead, he ran away. And Saul and all of his soldiers keep on chasing David. Until one day, Saul died. And because of that, David took the responsibility to become a king. But he was ordained before that to be the next king. The point of saying this, just to let you know the power of friendship. Saul died, Jonathan died. Everyone in Saul's and Jonathan's family died. But look at the heart of David. David asked the people, do you know anybody that belongs to Jonathan's family? Is there anyone left from the family of Jonathan? Because David wants to share the benefits of having a friend like Jonathan. And then someone told David, oh yeah, there is a family of David that lived in that lower bar. His name is Mephibosheth, the son of Jonathan. And Mephibosheth is a person who was a victim of a civil war at that time. He could not walk by himself. Because of that war. And David said, I want that man, that person, to go to the palace. And he sent some of his soldiers to get him. But Mephibosheth, because he was influenced, brainwashed by all of those people, Mephibosheth has some kind of fear and anger towards David, because he was brainwashed that David captured their territory, that David killed all of his family. There's an anger, bitterness in his heart. But David said, I want that man to be in the palace. He came and sat down with David in a long table, eating together. And David says, the only reason I'm doing this to you because of my friendship with your father, Jonathan. My friend, I want all of you to know